अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द लेक्चर नंबर 41 फॉर द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम्स। नाउ दिस लेक्चर इज़ अबाउट बेसिक इंट्रोडक्शन टू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ कंकरेंसी। हेयर आर द डिफरेंट ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस लेक्चर। वी विल डिस्कस द नीड ऑफ कंकरेंसी एंड द डेफिनेशन ऑफ कंकरेंसी। देन वी विल डिस्कस डिफरेंट प्रिंसिपल्स एंड प्रॉब्लम्स, एडवांटेजेस, ड्रॉबैक्स एंड इशूज रिलेटेड टू concurrency in operating systems. Now our modern operating systems are organized around different techniques like multi-programming. जैसे हमने बात की कि हमारे पास single programming system थे जिसमें हमारे पास single application थी जो हर time पर run करती थी, किसी और application को entertain नहीं करते। So in order to be more productive and more effective, we introduced the multi-programming model in which we have multiple jobs residing in the ready queue and waiting for their turn for execution. So in multi-programming we have multiple processes residing in the memory. Then we have tightly coupled multiprocessing. We have multiple processors in a single computer system and there are different processes or jobs that need to compete for this. Then we have loosely coupled distributed processing systems in which we have multiple computer systems that are attached over a network and the tasks are distributed among these processes. So agar aap in tino scenario ko dekhen, we can have cooperating processes as well. So the big issue is concurrency, that how we can manage the interaction of all these processes so that they can be executed in a well ordered and well coordinated manner. So what is concurrency? Concurrency is the execution of multiple instruction sequences at the same time. Now it happens when there are several process threads running in parallel. Jaise humne pehle baat ki ki agar hamare paas multiple processors hain to hum multiple processes ko run kar sakte hain, and if we have multiple cores then we can run multiple threads at the same time. So concurrency happens when multiple threads of a single process or multiple process are running in parallel. Now these threads communicate with each other via using message passing system or shared memory system. So it means that we have to ensure a mechanism for their communication so that they can share the data and resources. And we also have to ensure that these threads are protected from one another. So concurrency demands sharing of resources and may result in deadlock or starvation situation. Concurrency helps us in coordinating process execution. It helps in memory allocation to different processes, just like the dynamic linking libraries, and it can maximize the throughput and performance of our system. Now what are the principles of concurrency? Both interleaved and overlapped processes can be viewed as an example of concurrent processes. However, the relative speed of execution cannot be predicted because we don't know the activities to be performed in a process. We simply don't know that how operating system handles interrupts, and that what data structures are used in operating system and how fast are these data structures. And then we are also unaware of the scheduling policies used by an operating system. So concurrency has to deal with a number of factors. Now what are the different problems in concurrency? The first problem is sharing a global resource. The best example of a global resource is a global variable. Now how it is a problem? Suppose we have two processes P1 and P2, and we have one or suppose we have two threads T1 and T2, and we have a global variable G. Now if both the threads aim at writing to the thread to the global variable at the single time, now what will happen? We will have readers writers problem. Jaise humne readers writer problem mein discuss kiya ki hum ek time par sirf ek writer ko hi अलाउ कर सकते हैं कि वो शेयर्ड रिसोर्स को यूज़ करे, जबकि अगर कोई रीड ओनली रिसोर्स है तो उसको मल्टीपल रीडर्स जो हैं वो सेम टाइम पर रीड कर सकते हैं. सो हाउ वी कैन हैंडल द शेयरिंग सेफली, दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम. द सेकंड प्रॉब्लम इज़ ऑप्टिमल एलोकेशन ऑफ रिसोर्स. we have a number of threads and we have number of processes, how we can manage resources optimally, that none of the resource is left underutilized and none is left overutilized. Similarly, we cannot locate programming errors as we have only executable files, and secondly, debugging of concurrent applications is difficult. Now, multi-threaded applications are popular in concurrency, like we have library in Java multi-threading and we have POSIX thread library. All these libraries are used to get the benefit of concurrent execution. So programmers basically write applications so that they can get advantage of multi-threaded applications. So is code ki wajah se jo hai wo concurrency occur karti hai. So if there is an error, we cannot locate the error or we cannot debug the error. Then locking the channel is another problem. If an operating system locks a channel for a group of processes or threads, it is highly inefficient, because if the processes or threads are not communicating, the channel capacity or the resource is simply underutilized. Then we have advantages of concurrency. The first advantage is that we can run multiple threads from same or different applications at the same time. So when different threads run at the same time, response is given to every job or every thread. So this improves the response time. Similarly, the usage of resources can be optimized or utilization can be made much better. For example, अगर एक job किसी एक resource को utilize कर रही है, तो कोई दूसरा thread किसी और free resource को utilize कर सकता है. So this basically improves system performance. Like if we have two threads or processes, so if one process is using CPU, other can use the printer, and the first one wants to use the CPU, the printer, the second one can switch to the CPU. So this increases the throughput of our system. Now what are the different drawbacks of concurrency? We have to protect one application code and global variables from other application. We have to coordinate multiple applications and multiple threads, so we require some form of communication and synchronization mechanism. Then there are additional overheads to manage communication. We either create mailboxes or we either use the message passing system, and then we use different primitives for message passing and shared memory. Then we have the synchronization problem. For this we have semaphore variables and mutex locks are used. So these are basically overheads. So in certain cases, too much concurrency can lead to performance degradation as well. Now, what are the issues in concurrency? The first issue is non-atomicity. The operations that are non-atomic but interruptible by multiple processes can cause different problems. So operating system has to deal with this issue. Then race condition is also an issue. A race condition occurs if the outcome depends on which the several processes get to the first point. जैसे हमने synchronization में पढ़ा कि हमारे पास critical section है, और critical section से पहले entry section है, exit section है, तो critical section को हम multiple applications में share नहीं कर सकते. अगर share करेंगे तो race conditions occur करेंगी. So जब हमारे पास concurrent processes हैं, so race conditions can occur. So we need proper synchronization mechanism in order to avoid this. Then we have the blocking problem. A process could be blocked for a long period of time waiting for input from a terminal, and terminal device is busy with some other process. Then starvation can occur. Starvation occurs when a process does not obtain services to progress at all, while other processes are receiving services regularly. Then we have the deadlock problem. The deadlock problem occurs when two or more processes are blocked and looking at each other to release resources so that they can continue their execution. So these are different issues in concurrency. Now what are the operating system concerns about concurrency? First of all, operating system has to keep record of all the processes. Then operating system has to manage the allocation and deallocation of resources in a well-organized and coordinated manner in order to avoid deadlock and ensure the proper utilization of resources as well. Then operating system has to protect data and other resources in a multi-threaded or multi-processing application. Similarly, operating system has also need to ensure that input and output is independent of CPU speed, जिसके लिए हमने DMA का कॉन्सेप्ट डिस्कस किया, डायरेक्ट मेमोरी एक्सेस का, जिसमें DMA कंट्रोलर क्या करता है, विदाउट CPU इंटरवेंशन कंट्रोल्स द ट्रांसफर ऑफ डाटा फ्रॉम वन डिवाइस टू अनदर डिवाइस. सो इफ वी हैव क्लाइंट सर्वर एप्लीकेशन, वी कैन हैव सॉकेट्स और पाइप्स फॉर मैनेजिंग द कम्युनिकेशन. सो ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम हैज़ टू डील विद नंबर ऑफ इशूज इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोवाइड कंकरेंसी और in order to get the advantage of concurrency. So this was our lecture about basic concepts and with concurrency.